Like and subscribe now, or you're going to have bad luck this week.
Everyone has fantasized about what it would be like to win the lottery. The appeal of the big payoff exists in everyone's mind. After all, it only takes a dollar and a dream, right? Imagine what you could do with even just $1 million, let alone 500 million. But the 10 people on this list are proof that Lady Luck isn't always so kind. They reached a degree of wealth that the rest of us can only dream about. Unfortunately, they blew it all. Let's have a look at them. Number one is the most shocking you will hear today, so don't forget to watch till the end. Number 10, Evelyn Adams. There are people that just have it in them. Evelyn Adams won the lottery on two separate occasions, that too back to back in the same year. She can be considered as one of the luckiest people on the planet. Some people never win the lottery. She actually won twice. The first time she won was in 1985, and the second time was in 1986. In total, she won over $5.4 million. However, she had to go the extra mile and test her fortune once again. Here comes the punchline. She lost it all. She was a greedy, compulsive gambler who managed to waste over $5 million. More than 35 years later, she's broke. The lavish lifestyle living in Atlantic City and Las Vegas solely for the purpose of gambling can't end well. We know that the casino always wins, but it isn't every day that they win back this big. She had to be on our top 10 stupid lottery winners list. The New Jersey native today resides in a trailer park. Number 9, Alex and Rhoda Toth. We all hope for that happily ever after. Many of us believe that a lottery is a powerful tool sent from the heavens above to change our lives for the better. In many instances, this is indeed the case. A few stories out there, however, serve as a constant reminder that money isn't the answer to all life's problems. It has turned into the demise of many people. Such was the case with the Florida couple Alex and Rhonda Toth, who hit the jackpot in 1990 when they won $13 million in the Florida lottery. But by 2006, they were living in squalid conditions, their only electricity coming from a power cord that was rigged to their car engine. Alex died while awaiting trial for tax evasion. Rhonda tried to dodge the feds by claiming she was too ill to stand trial. Unfortunately for her, the agents videotaped her moving around without the aid of crutches or a wheelchair. She was sentenced to 2 years in prison and ordered to pay $1.1 million to the IRS. Number 8, Edna May Urquhart. Edna May Urquhart was playing the lottery for 18 years when she won the Mega Millions jackpot of a breathtaking $51 million. However, according to her statements, in order to avoid pressure from family members and the media attention, she decided to give the winning ticket to her son, Ronnie Orender. Even though he promised to take care of his 76-year-old mother and his 79-year-old stepfather, the son went on a spending spree, ignoring his mother's wishes. After Orender had bought 4 homes and 10 cars, Etna decided that her son needed to be stopped and filed a lawsuit against him. The judge froze his assets, and almost a year after the lawsuit was filed, the two parties managed to reach a settlement. The terms of the agreement weren't disclosed, but whatever the case is, it's obvious that Urquhart lost a huge amount of her winnings due to poor judgment. Lesson of the story, never trust anyone, not even your own son. Number 7, Michael Carroll. Michael Carroll is a disgraced lottery jackpot winner who won £9.7 million in 2002 at the tender age of 19. Carroll didn't have the best idea when it comes to spending or investing the money. He blew most of it on cocaine. To solidify his rich man status, Carroll snorted the cocaine using solid gold pens. It was obvious that the money would be over sooner than later. Apart from buying a mansion, Carroll was known for a couple of other wasteful purchases and for paying prostitutes for their services quite often. Carroll splurged his cash on hookers, a backdoor racetrack, and sank into a $2,000 a day coke habit. By 2012, Michael had managed to lose all of his millions. Carroll was jailed for 5 months for drug offenses in 2004 and later moved to Scotland after hitting rock bottom. He went on to feature in TV docs about his fantastic fall from fortune. Today, Michael Carroll works at a cookie factory in Scotland. He says that he is happy regardless of the fact that his weekly salary is 204 pounds. Number 6. Alex Essoc. Alex Essoc won approximately $500,000 and used most of the money to fund his NGO, which was into supporting sexual abuse victims. Everything was fine for a couple of years. The NGO was very active. People were aided, and he was a lifesaver. Not long after that, the word was out that Alex was a sex offender himself on two occasions. Back in 1993 and in 2000, he molested two girls under the age of 13. Shortly after the word was out in the public, he was encountered by a few men who caused him severe injuries by hitting him on his head with a steel pipe. He previously did his time in jail, but why do you need to get the attention of the public by funding an NGO that serves the purpose to healing the victims of your crimes? Maybe because he wanted some redemption. It's too late for that for him, for all I know. Number 5. Amanda Clayton. She became a millionaire after winning the state lottery, Make Me Rich. To be honest, she doesn't deserve much of your time. She won $1 million and she continued to take her food stamps. Why would anyone do that? Isn't $1 million enough? It's not the Powerball jackpot, but it still is more than enough not to take food stamps and live on welfare. She was found guilty of charges for welfare fraud. Her sentence was 9 months of probation and a $5,500 fine. In the end, she died of a drug overdose. Imagine being this lucky and still being that dumb. She definitely deserves a place on our list. Number 4. William Bud Post. The story of William Bud Post reads like a Hollywood script. His mother died when he was 8 years old, and his father sent him to an orphanage shortly after the funeral. Post spent most of his life as a drifter until that fateful day in 1988, when he bought a Pennsylvania lottery ticket and landed the $16.2 million jackpot. However, within months, Post was broke, having spent massive amounts of money on houses, cars, boats, and shady business deals, and a twin-engine airplane, even though he had no pilot's license. He lost everything when the state confiscated everything from him after ill use of money. Post died penniless in 2006 of respiratory failure. "I was much happier when I was broke," he once confided. You don't hear that much these days. Number 3. Willie Hurt. Willie Hurt was a happy family man with a good reputation in his community. In 1989, his life changed forever when he won a $3.1 million jackpot in the Michigan lottery. The change was everything but good. The money basically ruined Hurt's life, who instead of investing in his and his children's future, decided to spend it on crack and a messy divorce. Hurt lost his wife, custody of his children, and he was even charged with attempted murder. Many believe that the first mistake he did after hitting the lottery was his decision to receive the prize by an annual payment of $156,000 instead of taking the lump sum. Possibly, if he had gotten and invested the whole amount rather than simply spending away with the payments, things would have unraveled differently. Either way, Hurt remains one of the stupidest as well as saddest examples of how money is not always the answer. Number 2. Jonathan Vargas. Hurt managed to ruin his life with only $3 million. Imagine what $35.3 million did to a 19-year-old Jonathan Vargas from Florida. The teenager hit the Powerball back in 2008 and completely failed to recognize the potential the money had by investing them in the weirdest projects a person can think of. Vargas decided to partner with Jimmy Hart to start an all-female wrestling league under the name of Wrestlelicious. Even though he always had a passion for pro wrestling, he should have known that the project is unlikely to attract the expected attention. After Wrestlelicious failed, Vargas made several other bad investments and faced big losses that resulted in him being broke. We hope that at least he enjoyed that sort of period of being a millionaire, and that if luck visits him again, he won't do the same mistake as the first time. Number 1. Justin Ritter. By now, you are probably expecting the worst. We know that money does change people. It can change them so much that it has to reach a final step. Justin Ritter, who lived in Alberta, Canada, won about $600,000. He didn't seem like much of a stable guy to begin with, but nobody expected that he could do something so stupid that would eventually kill him. The facts are as follows. It's a parody of the movie called Goldfinger with James Bond. He had the idea to replicate the actions of the villain, who happened to color the man's parts in gold. Before he did the unthinkable, he painted his inanimate parts with lead-based paint. It just didn't feel enough, so he went the extra mile by actually painting the area with gold. Not long after the procedure, he passed away. Doctors say that the cause of death was the lead-based paint. We just want to ask, why, Justin? Why? This is our list of 10 dumbest lottery winners of all time. What would you do if you won a huge lottery? Tell us in the comments, and if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel.